Welcome to the first course of blockchain specialization titled The Blockchain Basics. And let's get started by asking a very simple but important question. What is a blockchain? Why should you care about it? So in this video, I'll talk about that. So let's get started with the topic. Quick disclaimer, I am not a financial advisor. Alright, now let's get right into this course on blockchain. But before we start with talking about blockchain and some amazing features and just things you need to know about blockchain in general, I do want to tell you that if you want to find any content we'll talk about, then all the links will be down in the description. So check them out. Alright, so the first thing we need to talk about is what is a blockchain, alright? Because it's a very difficult concept to grasp first glance, but if you actually understand the concept, it's actually pretty well understandable. So a blockchain is basically a distributed database or ledger that is shared among the nodes of a computer network. And as a database, a blockchain stores information electronically in digital format. And believe me, this will make sense in a moment. But blockchains are best known for their crucial role in cryptocurrency systems such as Bitcoin. Bitcoin runs on a blockchain, but you don't necessarily need a crypto for a blockchain. But blockchains are mainly used for maintaining a secure and decentralized record of transactions, for example, Bitcoin. And the innovation with a blockchain is that it guarantees the fidelity and security of a record of data and generates trust without the need for a trusted third party, which is decentralization. But we'll talk about that a little bit later as well. So basically, just to get back to the basics, it's a database. It's a database of transactions and other data. But for example, with Bitcoin, it's mainly transactions, right? But you also have Ethereum, that's a different crypto and a different blockchain. And there you can also store data on that. And what it makes a blockchain is that it is a chain of different blocks. And all of those blocks are filled with that data or transactions. And they're all secured by different nodes. So you have all of these different computers all over the world sharing the same blocks, sharing the same data, keeping the blockchain working. So now a little bit more about how a blockchain works. So the goal of a blockchain is to allow digital information to be recorded and distributed, but not edited. All right, just recording and distributing. And in this way, a blockchain is the foundation for immutable ledgers or records of transactions that cannot be altered, deleted, or destroyed. And this is why blockchains are also known as distributed ledger technology, or DLT. And you might see that abbreviation more often. So here you can also see a beautiful graph of the transaction process, in this case for Bitcoin. So basically what happens is that when a new transaction is entered, so someone wants to send a Bitcoin to someone else, this is transmitted to a network of peer-to-peer computers, those nodes which we talked about. So this network then of computers, one of these computers is able to solve an equation to confirm the validity of the transaction, and they are then allowed to create a block. So then all of these transactions, multiple transactions, are clustered together in a block. The block is confirmed with that equation, and then it's added to the blockchain. So as we talked about briefly earlier, one of the greatest features of a blockchain is decentralization. So what you should practically imagine is that a company owns a server farm with 10,000 computers to maintain a database holding all of its clients' account information. So this company owns a warehouse building that contains all of these computers under one roof and has full control of each of these computers and all the information contained with them. But this, however, provides, as you might expect, a single point of failure. It's all brought under one roof. One party is controlling it. What happens if something happens? For example, in this analogy, that the electricity at the location goes out, or the internet connection is severed, or what if it burns to the ground? If this happens, all of the data is lost or corrupted, and blockchain has a solution for this. So what blockchain does, and that also brings us back to what we already talked about with those computers all over the world storing the same database, is that it allows the data to be held in a database that is spread out among several network nodes, various locations. And all of these nodes, and a node is basically a computer, someone storing the data, validating the data, in cooperation with all of the other people doing that all over the world. You have people doing this in North America, people doing it in China, Russia, Europe, Africa, South America, and everywhere around the world. That actually allows the data to be decentralized. If one node goes down, it is still stored and the data is still correct. And that's one of the greatest benefits of blockchain. It's secure and it's strong. Now, some other benefits of decentralization, for example, are also that it facilitates a trustless setting. People know it's decentralized, so they don't have to trust the system. the system works. It improves data recovery because, as I said, one node goes down, the data is still there. It reduces degrees of shortcoming and it has optimized assets dispersion. Now, one of the biggest questions with blockchain is it secure? Is it safe? Because blockchain technology achieves decentralized security and trust in several ways. To begin with, for example, new blocks are always stored linearly and chronologically. And that is that they are always added to the end of the block. Chain. That's also where the name comes from. And after a block has been added to the end of the blockchain, it is extremely difficult to go back and alter the contents of a block unless a majority of the network has reached a consensus to do so. So this is practically impossible. You have more and more nodes securing the network, and all of these nodes, even though they are working together, cannot work together on doing something like this. It is technically possible, but practically it is almost not. Now, even though a blockchain inherently is very strong, there are still cases in crypto where there have been pretty big hacks. And that usually has to do with applications of blockchain and crypto technology, which is more difficult, such as networks that are different from Bitcoin. Bitcoin has a proven model and is secured, but there are other networks that are different, have been designed differently, that can actually have flaws. And that's always why you have to do great analysis and great research on that. But you also have certain bridges which actually allow you to transfer cryptos from one blockchain to a different one. So even though blockchains in general are secure, that is not general for every network out there. So you should still always do great research. All right, so with that, we've reached the end of this video. If you found this video helpful, please make sure to add a like and add comments with questions I might have missed, and subscribe to our channel.